wants to kill people because something that happened in the past at the 86 explosion attack. Dog this game. No, this is some fucking liberal bullshit. This is straight up propaganda.
Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people. Hey, all you people, won't you listen to me? Hi. Hi there, I'm Karina McDaniels, and I found a really bad review on the internet that I want to talk about. It's really funny, and I think y'all will like it too. So, for some background information, I played the game Road 96. I normally don't care much for walking simulators, but I read that this one was really good, and one of my Discord friends gifted me a copy of it, and I gotta say, I was pleasantly surprised. If you've never played it before, Road 96 is a walking sim-esque game that's about the world of Petria being controlled by a dictator named Tyrak, who's strongly associated with the color red. Gee, I wonder who that's supposed to represent. There's also a blue candidate too? Gee, I wonder which election this is supposed to be a metaphor for. I wonder. But believe it or not, that's actually a massive oversimplification of this game, because this world is pretty complicated. This game is very political in nature, but it's also very character-driven. Your goal as the faceless, nameless protagonist is to reach the border via the titular Road 96. Along the way, you meet a myriad of different characters, including a criminal duo, who I liked a lot, Gerard, who is one of the more tragic characters, Sonia, whose story is actually also pretty tragic now that I think about it. All of these characters' stories are related in one way or another, and depending on your playthrough, you might end up having a lot of pieces missing. What mainly made me like this game is its Reservoir Dogs-style non-linear storytelling. This is one of the few games that do this type of storytelling, and it's a big way to get you into doing more than one playthrough. You have to in order to get the full story. Describing it as a walking sim might be derogatory nowadays, but it actually has a lot more to it than that, because you make choices that can majorly affect main characters that you meet. Needless to say, there's a lot of endings to the game, and I didn't get all of them, sadly, but I wish I could show you clips, but this is a game you should experience for yourself. Since it's heavily story-driven, I don't like showing spoilers if I don't have to. I would say if you're into very story-heavy games, this is one of the best ones I've played in a long time, if that means anything. It's got a very Borderlands-esque art style to it, and the voice acting is pretty excellent overall. Now that you know the basic gist of the game, now we can talk about this really bad review of it. And I mean no exaggeration in the title, this is quite possibly one of the worst game reviews I've ever come across. I would be shocked if I come across something worse. If you think you found one worse than this, then be my guest and tell me, because I don't think you can find one worse than this. So there I was, let me set everything up for you. So there I was, minding my own beeswax, when all of a sudden, like a fart in a crowded elevator, this YouTube video showed up in my recommended feed. I guess Google just knew what I recently played or something, you know. Google's the world's greatest stalker, because that's the only way I can explain how this video showed up in my recommended. This is a 2-minute and 40-second review of this game, and oh boy, that title. Oh boy, that title. That's what sold me on this video. I just had to know. I was too curious. Wow, am I glad I trusted my gut, because this video was... this video was hilarious.
Road 96, what's about? Pretty simple premise. You're in a tyrannical government where this president wants to kill teenagers. Do you know why? No. But you have six teenagers trying to get across the border, and at the meantime, you're running into a cop, a truck driver, another random teen, this really annoying 13-year-old genius, these bank robbers, a news reporter, and this crazy guy that wants to kill people because something that happened in the past at the 86 explosion attack.
Alright, stop. I find it really odd how you put tyrannical government in sarcastic quotations. I mean, dude, this is a place where cops openly beat protesters and kill political dissenters. That's the definition of tyrannical. Also, this tyrannical dude wants to do more than just kill teenagers. I don't know why you'd phrase it like that. Oh, this is already funny. Please continue digging your grave.
Dog this game. No. This is some fucking liberal bullshit. This is straight up propaganda. This was trash galore.
Ah, shit. Here we go again.
And that, right there, is what had me giggling for a long time. A statement like that perfectly, mwah, chef's kiss, perfectly encapsulates anti-SJW brain rot that I dislike so much. This is the thought process of 99% of the Phantom Menace. This is Geeks and Gamers and his 5,000 clones. This is Yellow Flash 2, this is Mecha Random 42, etc, etc, ek fucking cetera. This is the quintessential bad cuz woke video that infested the YouTube algorithm for years in the post-Gamergate era. Except this video was posted like 2 weeks ago. Really think about that. 2 weeks ago. This was posted 2 weeks ago. People were already getting tired of the shit around like 2019. And 2019 was 5 years ago. Really let that sink in. That's incredible. But why is this game woke and therefore bad? Well, I'm not quite sure yet because he's hardly said anything. He just kind of mentioned all the characters and the terrorist attack that kicked off the many of the character motivations. Nothing about what he said so far screams woke. Not even like fake woke or anything. Just nothing so far. So please, sir, please provide me with the nails to hammer into your coffin.
Every time they're like trying to make a thing like revolution or vote or just, oh, I hope everything's okay. I hope everything's okay. I donated to the quote unquote dictator, if you want to put it that way, because there's nothing in this game to make me go the other way or the other because.
Now at this point, I'm getting a little skeptical. By that, I mean, I'm not even sure if you even played this game. I mean, because if you did, you must have been sleepwalking through it, because if you were paying attention at all, you would see how bad this dude really was. It's not like you have to wonder, or it all happens off screen or something like that. It all happens pretty much in front of your eyes. Characters talk about it all the time.
Because it forcefully says, one person's bad, one person's good. Hint, 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 and you're just like,
okay, first of all, what the fuck was that? Did you just have a stroke? More importantly, no, that's just flat out not true. The rival politician of Tyrant, who's Flores, is very flawed. It's pointed out in the game. Again, hard to miss if you're paying attention. How do you get something this wrong?
The graphics were, I understand what they're doing with the graphics, but it didn't work for me. Like I said, this is a very one-dimensional game where it's basically like, oh, this one person's always bad, and it's just, like I said.
And again, that isn't true, but also it's worth considering that this game isn't necessarily plot-driven, it's character-driven. Those are two very different things. Anyone who plays this game for more than 30 minutes has figured this out already. It's less about the destination and more about the journey.
The agenda on this game, I understand some agendas, like, you know, the Wolfenstein game, RC and Call of Duty, sure, movies galore, sure. But Road 96, it was a chore to get through, it was laughable with the dialogue, especially that genius character, shut the fuck up.
Again, there's more of this agenda bullshit. Hey, to all the dipshit reviewers out there, pointing out that a piece of media has an agenda is not criticism. Pointing out this has agenda, not valid criticism. Also, what fucking agenda? You have yet to point to anything that would even vaguely imply an agenda. What, because this guy kinda reminds you of Trump and people don't like him, therefore agenda?
I'm gonna come. Oh.
I mean, that's all you've brought up so far. If that's the standard for woke, well then fuck, most things are woke by that standard. I also have to wonder whether or not you have functional hearing at all, because the voice acting is actually pretty good. Is it the best? Maybe not. But you have never seen The Flash before if you think this game's dialogue is bad.
Wait, he's Batman?
Yeah, don't watch The Flash. It's really fucking bad. He puts a baby in a microwave at some point. Yeah, it's pretty bad.
My God, though, but this game was fucking garbage. I hated it. It was stupid. Even though I still got 100% achievements, I sucked it up and I said, let me finish this game. But my God, this is a liberal, cesspool, progressive, AOC, the squad type of game.
Whoa, hold on a second. Hold your horses, sir. Did this motherfucker just say he got 100% achievements? Holy shit, where do I even begin? Okay. All right. The fact that you played this game front to back and got this many things just flat out wrong really says a lot about you. None of which is good. Okay, assuming that you're telling the truth, which I have reasons to doubt, but assuming you're telling the truth, I want to know why. Why did you even do it in the first place? I think you knew you were going to hate this game well before your first playthrough was done. So why even complete it fully? It wasn't to change your own mind. You didn't need to complete it to do that. It wasn't to make a more accurate review, because clearly you didn't even do that. It wasn't to understand the characters better, because you would have brought that up in the review if you had anything to say about it. So the impression I get from you is that you're just not very intelligent. You wasted your own time beating it and making a review that mentions nothing, and you wasted my time by farting this nonsensical opinion out of your ass. It's just, nothing is making sense here. You explained nothing. Did you know you can make choices in this game? Did anybody know you can make choices in this game? That's a pivotal game mechanic. I've never heard it mentioned once in this review. You wouldn't know about this pivotal mechanic listening to this review. That's egregious. That is fucking egregious. That's not even a rookie mistake. That's a I have no clue what I'm doing kind of mistake. Dude, come on. You know what? This reads less like a review and more like a hot take on Twitter. You know, one that completely misses the point of everything in order to be contrarian with no regards to accuracy or evidence. It's not like reviews can't be 3 minutes. That's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying your review can't be 3 minutes long. They can be. It's just really hard to pull off. It's really hard for even the best people to pull off. And this is done so incredibly poorly, I can't even say you tried. I really can't even say that you put an effort in here. This is a F triple minus level effort. As opposed to someone like, oh, I don't know, Geeks and Gamers, who at least puts in a solid D minus effort. Oh, you know it's bad when Geeks and Gamers is less lazy than you are. That's a genuine accomplishment. You know, you deserve an award for that, if anything. I'm serious, you deserve an award. I didn't think a game review can be farted into existence. Until now. Okay, I'm lying. That's actually not true. I did know that video game reviews could be farted into existence. I read Kotaku.
Ha! Gotti! Gotti!
Yeah, you may not believe me. That's the whole video. Holy shit, that was a doozy. Yeah, that was awful. Oh, that was pretty awful. But, as a silver lining, I took a trip down to ye old comments section of this video and summarized how I felt about it. You can read that right here. What's great about this entire comments section is just every person down here is just clowning on him. all of the most liked comments on this video are just making fun of him and laughing at him. You got to believe that warmed my heart greatly. It was beautiful. It was funny. And it was beautiful. Now, since this video is over here, you might think I have nothing else to talk about, right? But that's where you're wrong. I got some more nice and juicy content right here in the comments section. Now, no doubt there's going to be people who will tell me, oh, Karina, oh, what a fool you are. This man is obviously trolling. You fell for a troll, you moron. Oh, my poor, poor friend. Oh, I feel bad for you. You're about to figure out how wrong you are once we look at some of this guy's responses to the comments down here. They are golden. Trust me, they are golden. So this commenter writes, "Bro is stuck in 2016, skull emoji." A pretty boy responds with, "Yet the game came out in 2021. However, 2016 was a wild year." I'm trying to sound like comic book guy from The Simpsons. Was that good? I don't know if that was good. I was trying. Anyway, this response was funny because homie just missed the entire point of the comment. He's not talking about the game, dipshit. He's talking about you. And he's right. Your content is like if 2016 was a YouTube video. Going further down in the thread reveals something really funny. Apparently our boy didn't even know the game he was buying was a walking sim. It's all just blind buying. Look, alright, like, I'm not gonna be a gatekeeper on how people should spend their money, but I can't make sense out of that. Money is just too tight nowadays to be doing that. I research everything I buy. Blind buying is just alien to me. Whatever, I guess. I just found that kind of crazy. This commenter writes, "Laughable dialogue. That's rich coming from you." Our boy writes, "They wrote a script. I didn't."
Huh?
Oof. Oh, oof. Oof. That's a mega oof right there. Was that supposed to be a burn? Because after listening to this video, the only person who looks stupid right now is you. You really should have considered doing that. You really should have considered writing a script. Look, there's no shame in it. I would not have judged you negatively if you wrote a script for it. There's no shame in it. I write a script. I'm reading from a script literally right now. You want to know why? You want to know why I do that? Because it's easier for me to get a coherent message across without filler bullshit getting in the way. I'm just saying. Oh, the sheer passive aggressiveness when he's responding to other people in this thread. If that makes you happy, then I'm happy. God, that level of passive aggression makes me want to stuff you in a locker, you young Sheldon-looking little fuck. Ooh, you're just asking to get slapped in the fucking face with that kind of attitude. Okay, so here's a commenter with some valid critique that is the second most liked comment on this video. Hey dude, maybe when you review something, you should take the time to actually talk about what you're looking at instead of screeching like a goblin about woke. Very valid, very valid. I said basically the same thing earlier. Our boy hits back with the obviously well thought out response, of course. Fine. A woke walking simulator where people complain with laughable agenda. Next. Now listen, I have nothing against being smug. A lot of my humor involves being smug. But I like to think that my smugness is at least charming. But this dude? Every time he's smug like this, I want to bitch slap him through a brick wall. This dude seriously deserves the most painful atomic wedgie in human history. Even worse than being grossly incorrect and smug about it, he also doesn't understand blatant sarcasm on top of it all. One guy in this thread says, "But if something is woke, then it's bad. And if something is bad, then it's woke." You can tell this is obviously sarcasm, but homie just unironically agrees with him. Holy shit. Every comment from this dude, you see what I'm talking about? Every comment from this dude is simply amazing. I just can't help but bust a gut laughing at his obliviousness. It's almost approaching lolcow territory. This dude seriously gives Cyrax a run for his money. Okay, maybe he's not that bad, but you know, just, it's lolcowsy. It's very lolcowsy. Just to dig his grave a little bit deeper, this commenter writes, "Road 96 has its issues, but this is an under 3 minute review that has no real critique of gameplay or story other than woke-ry." Another valid and fair criticism. Well, I would like to let you know that you'll be pleased to hear that our boy fully understands the points that were made, and he actually did the adult thing and admitted that he was wrong. In a parallel universe. In this universe, however, he instead responded with, "Okay, it is a pointless walking simulator. 5 seconds. Hey, yoo-hoo, Earth to dipshit. Hey, buddy. You do realize that that wasn't the only critique he had, right? This response is just, oh man. This response, like just hearing a response like that, it makes me want to kick you in the nuts hard enough to make you piss blood for a week. It just isn't just the smugness. It's the passive aggressive attitude combined with the fact that his opinions are so poorly reasoned. He reminds me so much of Flat Earthers. Flat Earthers are exactly this kind of smug. A smug so putrid it triggers your gag reflex. Another bizarre thing I noticed is that he's hearting comments that are unambiguously making fun of him. He's hearting comments that unambiguously mock him. Obviously, this is not something most creators do. It makes me suspicious that, it makes me a little bit suspicious that he might be trolling after all. I'm sure someone is already screaming at me that this dude is an obvious troll. Some people said this about Wrestling Otaku as well. If you don't know, that's a guy I talked about earlier. You can watch that video. I'll put it up in the cards. But here's why you're wrong. When one is to consider a patron of the internet to be trolling, one must first examine the potential motive behind the troll. Most commonly, it is to make the people laugh. This form of trolling often comes with disclaimers so that the troll cannot be confused with the person they are satirizing. Either that, or obvious social cues that it is meant to be taken as a joke and not serious at all. This video contains neither of these signs. Moreover, in order to consider someone for the role of troll, one must also examine the potential gain for said potential troll. In other words, what would the troll gain from their trolling efforts? For this example, the potential troll has done nothing more than convince me he is a moron with a poor attention span and is incredibly stubborn about taking criticism. This yields no obvious positives for the troll, leading one to question the point of it all. So what I'm basically saying is, if you're gonna try to tell me, bro, this dude's a troll, bro, you're fucking stupid, this guy's obviously a troll, please consult with what I just said earlier, and that should help you understand why you're incorrect, okay? Alright, can we move past that now? Alright, we're all gonna move past that. So here's some more funny comments that we can ruthlessly mock him for. This person lays out a lot of valid criticism, as well as explaining to this dunderhead that just because you take down a totalitarian government, that doesn't automatically make the game quote-unquote woke. Very smart, much agree, take my updute, stranger. But of course, the before-mentioned dunderhead has to come back with this beautiful gem. You have your opinion, and I have mine. My opinion is that the game sucks and has cringy woke dialogue and characters. Excuse me. Bro, for fuck's sake, that's not how commas work. Sorry, I'm terribly sorry. I just got triggered by his shitty grammar. Let's continue. You have your opinion, and good on you. Can't be mad at it. Christ on a bike, man. It's hard to even say anything about that. What do I say to that? All I can really say is, if missing the point was an Olympic sport, you'd be the Usain Bolt of that sport. Kotaku op-ed writers would stand in utter shock at your talents. This other commenter basically reiterates the same point as the last person and describing opposing a tyrannical government is not woke. That is correct. He also said this dude missed all the nuance of the game. That is also correct. The state of conservative media literacy, that's funny, that's just really funny, sorry. The state of conservative media literacy is so bad. I would argue they never had good media literacy, but then that would be implying that the left is better at it, which that would be quite a stretch to say, but regardless, our boy responds with, tell me why Tyrak wants the teens in the camp. Remember, I want you to remember when you hear that, remember, this man supposedly played through the game at least 6 times to get all the achievements, and he knows this little about the story. That's impressively dumb. You thought the GameSpot review for Doom was bad? Holy shit. You thought the Cuphead guy was bad at video games? Well, I think we found someone worse. If not, then at least I found a guy who somehow manages to 100% a game and not understand the basic story elements. Okay, rant over. He continues showcasing his ignorance with the next few sentences. There's no backstory besides blowing up the dam and everyone falls in line. What he's talking about is the terrorist attack of 1986, where they tried to assassinate Tyrak. They failed and killed a lot of innocent people, so now he's paranoid. Dictator is paranoid, okay? Which leads him to killing all political dissenters. There you go. It ain't that hard. That wasn't in some audio log. That wasn't some obscure thing that I just pulled out of nowhere. That is flat out told to you in the story. But yet he continues. The woke is the dialogue of the characters. That's not a proper sentence, but okay. Sure, there's fine characters, like the dad who lost his daughter. But the kid with the glasses was horrible. That character was not gray. This dude really does have an amazing ability to talk forever and say nothing. He won't go into detail about anything he just said. Probably because he, if you ask me, it's probably because he didn't actually play the game. I mean, sure, the video had to be 3 minutes maybe, but the comment could be as long as you want, and yet you still explain nothing. It's really hilarious and kind of sad at the same time. In case you thought he was done doubling down, nope. Nope, he ain't done yet. You ain't seen shit yet. Here's another person wondering why he thinks the game is woke. He gets hit with the, because the dialogue of the character is in agenda, maybe. It's just comical at this point. I'm seriously convinced this dude, like, read a review on Bounding Into Comics or some other shit rag website, and he formulated his entire opinion based on that. Remember, this guy uploads 3 videos a day, at least. This channel that I got this video on, he uploads 3 videos a day. You can verify that. Dude has the classic Phantom Menace upload schedule. That is very consistent with Geeks and Gamers, who I think he's kind of trying to rip off, to be honest, and doing a frankly horrible job at. Consistently just pumping liquid shit into the collective conscience of the interwebs. I wouldn't be surprised if this dude was like plagiarizing other people or just flat out being lazy and not actually reading anything that he reviews. That wouldn't shock me. Oh, well, shit, I can feel my brain going numb, so that's a good indication I should probably stop. I'm hoping we all had fun today at the expense of this really bad game review. I'm hoping everybody had a good belly laugh today. I know I sure did, and I'm glad I was able to share it with you today. Have a fantastic day. I'm Karina McDaniels, and up yours, woke moralists!